Welcome to this triple container home. I know the majority of Airbnbs I showcase on the channel are meant more for vacations, romantic getaways, couples, families, but these are called container living pods by the Airbnb host. I probably imagine the majority of the renters would be young professionals, maybe even students. I'd love to see more larger cities to repurpose shipping containers like this one behind me to make some very unique living spaces. So with all that said, let's now hop into a tour of this very unique shipping container home out here in Texas. For today's tour, we are located just on the outskirts of Houston, Texas, just a 10 to 15 minute drive into downtown. And here it is, your first glimpse of your triple shipping container home. It is made up of three separate living pods or three different 20-foot containers. You have the option to either book just one container, or if you want more privacy, you can book out all three containers, which is especially great if you're traveling with a group or your family to visit Houston. For the two containers up top, I love how the owner chose to keep the container doors open and to install some windows there. If we now come down to the ground floor, there's also a neat sign that says, "Find your repurpose." Next, on the left side, you have a grill and an outdoor dining table with six chairs. Something else that's really cool about this triple container home is that if you come back at night and you flick on all of the lights, you have this incredible view of the container. The exterior lighting is really on point. Lighting is just such an important part of any Airbnb listing, and it's often overlooked by a lot of hosts, but these guys just knocked it out of the park. You can even get a bit of a sneak peek into that second floor outdoor area. We're now going to begin to head inside, so we're gonna walk past that sign and round the corner, and you'll come to this little outdoor deck space. It has two chairs and a small table, and I was getting some work done. But now I'm going to put away my gear, walk up to the door, and open it on up, as it's time to finally go and check out the interior. Welcome to the first 20-foot living pod. This is the main room. You have your bed right in the middle and a little kitchenette along the back wall. Now, along this wall on the right, you have some cool art decorations. You also have your air conditioning unit up top, plenty of shelf space, and a smart TV. We'll now walk into this corner, which has some of the essentials waiting for you. You have this little table, actually an ironing board down below, and if we pan up top, you have some hangers. So definitely a little tight, I get it, but I think they packed a lot of amenities into this small space, also including this water dispenser. We'll now walk past the bed into this far corner to your kitchenette. You actually have a nice range hood up top with your fans and lighting, which helps to cover your two burners on your stovetop. Now, next to the burners, you have a little sink and actually some nice high quality kitchen knives. On the other side of the kitchen, you have some pots and pans and your coffee maker, even a microwave, a fridge, and a freezer are here. So again, for a pretty small space, I thought this was relatively well stocked. You even have some condiments here like your salt and pepper, your sugar, your tea bags, and in this final corner, you actually have a full-length mirror along this wall. We'll now head into this corner and slide the door back to walk into the bathroom inside of this 20-foot container. All of the walls in this space give it a bit of a luxurious feeling, in my opinion. You also have your sink area on the left with some storage space below, your toilet, and some beautiful tiling along the floor of the shower. The shower overall definitely was very clean and had a modern touch to it. We're now going to head back outside and walk up this long blue spiral staircase to head up to the second floor to check out the two other 20-foot containers. If we face one way, you'll notice you have a cool outdoor chill-out space further down, which I'll get to shortly. And the opposite way, you have the two white doors that lead into the two other containers. If we come to this far end though, you have this nice hammock. So if you're renting one of the top two containers or all three, this is a great space to unwind after a long day. After visiting the outdoor area, let's now head into container number two of three. And here is the second container. Definitely a pretty similar layout to the other one we saw. You have slightly less kitchen space, but it makes up for it with the lovely outdoor deck you'll see shortly. But you have some similar amenities like your water dispenser, microwave, and fridge. This entire shelf setup is a little more visible than the last unit, so you can see the ironing board and your remotes. If we now come to this wall on the left, hanging from the wall is another smart TV in this unit, and it comes fully equipped with Netflix, Hulu, and all of the major streaming companies. You can see more of the bed in this unit from this particular clip. But also in that far corner, you have some cool square shelf space and an outlet right below it, so you can charge your phone or other accessories right next to you while you sleep. I also tested out all of these beds and they were super comfy. Moving along, we'll now quickly pop outside to the outdoor deck. You have that same small table and the two chairs waiting for you. This is a great spot to either start your day with a cup of coffee or to end it with a beer or a cocktail. To finish off this container, we'll now briefly head into the bathroom. It's quite similar to the earlier bathroom we saw. The major difference is the paint job here. You have a bright blue color scheme versus the white version we saw downstairs. That's it for the second container, so we'll now head into the third and final container on the left. Now in the third container, I won't spend too much time in this unit. I noticed the biggest difference though was just the color of some of the items, such as the curtains and the bedding. You have the same setup of those major amenities along this wall though. And if we get a bit closer to the bed, you'll notice some more brightly colored artwork up here. All of the art pieces in these three different containers are different. I'll now walk past the fridge into this corner and pull back a chair. This is the final outdoor space that I'll highlight. If we step outside, you have another outdoor deck here with the two chairs and your circular table. I love this drone shot as well, as it paints a better picture of the layouts of these two 20-foot containers on the second floor. Last but not least, we'll head into the last bathroom, which has a similar setup, but you have these cool orange and black walls. Thanks for checking out my video, guys. If you want to see more container home tours, check out my container home playlist linked out in the video description. And until next time, I will see you very soon for another Airbnb tour.